Good morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to ASEM Live. This is ASEM Sports. The Premier League is back and on track, delivering mouthwatering games of football and soccer. 2023 came with a bang. It came in triples, it came in doubles. The games are coming fast and they are coming quick. Thank you for tuning in to ASEM Sports, the Premier League, the upper echelon. Liverpool losing to Brentford has been the topic of conversation in a soccer game that went down, where Brentford were able to beat Liverpool 3-1. Yesterday, in a clash for the supremacy on the top, where Arsenal, who are in first, were playing with Newcastle, who occupied the third position on the Premier League table. It ended up in a draw, and the game spoke more to Newcastle's defensive abilities than to Arsenal's offensive inability. The game was very heated. Few chances from both teams. Arsenal obviously were the most pressing side, but the defensive performance from Trippier and Dunn and Nick Pope, the Newcastle goalkeeper. This Newcastle team have a very strong squad, and tits my hat out to Eddie Howe with what he's been able to do and the whole new ownership, the Saudi consortium. But Newcastle are flying, and people are tipping Arsenal, since clearly it's easy to speak when things are going well for you. And Mikel Arteta has been able to transform this Arsenal squad. Very youthful squad. People kept saying that after Gabriel Jesus got injured, it would have been a problem, but they've been able to readjust and find a new structure with Eddie Nketiah and Bukayo Saka. I mean, they could have won the game yesterday, I must say. But you see, it's games like this that determine who wins the title. When it's crappy and it's rough and it's not too smooth, are you still able to secure that win? Great teams are able to do that. When it's scruffy and it's rough and it's there's no way out, somebody, match winner, will show up. And I don't wanna dump in the spirits of the Gunners, but I don't think Arsenal is there yet in terms of, it's a long season. They are first in January, but who knows what's gonna happen in March. Thank you for tuning in to ASEM Sports. Let me give you a rundown of the games that went down. Arsenal played 0-0 with Newcastle. Frank Lampard's wars with Everton are still continuing, and I don't know what Frank Lampard has to do. He walked off the field to boos from the Evertonian fans. Everton fans don't play around, but I don't know what Frank Lampard has to do. They are battling for relegation. The players on the field, at which point in time will sometimes players own up to their bullshit? You can have the greatest manager in the world, but when the players on the field are not dedicated to the manager's instructions or don't have the ability to carry it through, what do the manager do then? What should Frank Lampard do now? I mean, it's crazy. This has nothing against Frank Lampard. I'm not speaking just because I'm a Chelsea fan and he's a Chelsea legend. I'm just speaking from a perspective of someone who's played the game, who's coached the game, who watches the game, who has an intellectual understanding of the game. Sometimes you don't have the materials to deliver the goods. Thank you for tuning into ASEM Sports. So Brighton, who are playing very convincingly after Graham Potter left for a dream job at Chelsea, which has now become a nightmare for him, if you ask me. Brighton are still, Giuseppe, the new coach, the new Italian coach, who's at Brighton now, has really, I mean, he used to coach in the Spanish La Liga, I think, before he came to the Premier League, but his tactical genius is definitely something to look out for. Manchester United have found their winning ways, and the Red Devils are singing songs and praise too early. I mean, I'm just saying, you played against Bournemouth. Relax. Manchester United are definitely playing better under Erik ten Hag, but they haven't been truly tested. And the smartest thing that this Manchester United team organization did was purchasing Casemiro and Christian Eriksen. But it's going to be a long season. And for how long will Casemiro be able to stay within the rhythm of this rigorous league? So Manchester United playing well, kudos, beating Bournemouth. If you want to celebrate because you beat Bournemouth, it will tell you how low the standards have fallen. This is Manchester United, are you crying? Chelsea, on the other hand, still struggling, so I cannot even speak because my blues is very bluesy. Graham Potter has to work some magic. He has to call Harry. Harry, Graham Potter needs some magic. Because Chelsea are splurging money and buying all these players that we don't really need. We are buying defenders when, I mean, in as much as Thiago Silva and Koulibaly, it could be shaky. I mean, we still have a strong defensive line. Trevor, I mean, I don't know what is going on at this club, but they are stacking up defenders. It almost feels like if any player is on the market, Chelsea has to grab it. Like, we don't have to do impulse buying. We don't have to do panic buying. But this new ownership at Chelsea, I mean, do they know anything about football? Or they are just there for the business aspect of it? Chelsea fans, we need to rise up and look at what is going on. Graham Potter hasn't, I mean, I don't want to remind. Anyways, so today more games are going on. Chelsea problems will continue as they are playing against Manchester City on Thursday. We shall see. Southampton is playing Nottingham Forest today. Leeds United is playing West Ham. Aston Villa is playing against Wolves, a game that I'm really looking forward to. And Crystal Palace is playing against a Tottenham Hotspur who are just coming back from a loss. And Antonio Conte really has to prove what he's there for, because he was complaining that he doesn't have players, but it seems like Bentancur, Kulusevski, when these two key players are hurt, Tottenham has a problem. Thank you for watching Asub Sports. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0, a collection of songs by the musical king. New ASEM music collection, the Forecast 1.0, available on all platforms. This has been Asub Sports. We'll let you know coming soon. Over that time.